If you need a MacBook for portability, but the built-in graphics options just aren't powerful enough for your needs, an eGPU is the perfect answer. Simply buy an eGPU enclosure, like this $300 Razer Core X, and stick an AMD graphics card in for a major boost in graphics performance. Now the only question remains is which card do you buy? Well, in this video, we're comparing the eGPU performance of the top 3 AMD graphics cards to see which one is the best option. For our test machine, we've got a 16-inch MacBook Pro that's almost fully spec'd out except for not having 64 gigs of RAM. And for the graphics cards, we've got the Vega 64, which you can get for $385, the Radeon 7 for $550, and the recently released 5700 XT for $370. And I've gotta say that some of these results are very surprising, so stick around for all of the tests. We'll have links to all of these cards down in the description, so if this video helps you make a decision, you can use those links for the best price on each card. macOS just received an update that improved the performance of one of these cards, but as you'll see in a minute, it might not matter. Now before we get into graphics performance testing, I do wanna mention that we're using an older version of Final Cut Pro, since the latest one is using a brand new Metal 2 engine that isn't yet optimized for eGPUs, but there is a new version coming out very soon, so hopefully it should fix that. Getting right into it with Geekbench 5's metal test, the Radeon 7 comes out ahead, but not by that much considering the higher price tag. We were also expecting a bit more power out of the 5700 XT, but it turns out that there are still some driver issues that don't allow it to reach full performance unless you connect multiple monitors at once. With various configurations, MacRumors forum user BS Beamer was able to get metal scores as high as 70,000 with the 5700 XT using headless adapters, which tricked the system into thinking there is a display connected when there really isn't. We ended up connecting two displays and we got a metal score of 65,000, much better than we were able to get previously. So if you don't have two displays to connect to your eGPU, or if you don't want to use external displays at all, you can order a couple of those headless adapters using the links in the description below. This will get you better performance until Apple updates the drivers for the 5700 XT shortly. For example, in the Bruce X benchmark in Final Cut Pro 10, using dual monitors with the 5700 XT saved us 2 seconds over the card by itself, which was already surprisingly good. We then stabilized a 30 second 60p C200 RAW clip, and once again, the dual monitors or headless adapter solution helped the 5700 XT beat out the rest of the cards by a few seconds. However, in our 5 minute 4K H.264 export test, using dual monitors didn't help at all. In fact, the Radeon 7 was actually the winner in this test. Now onto exporting a 5 minute Canon RAW 60p clip, the 5700 XT finished the fastest, regardless of whether we were using dual displays or not, so it seems like it's a hit or miss on whether dual displays will help. We also tested the timeline playback of the same Canon RAW clip, and this time, using two monitors gave us a massive boost in frames per second, specifically 12 more FPS compared to using one monitor, which was already performing the best. We then took that same Canon RAW clip and imported it into DaVinci Resolve 16 because it can harness eGPUs very well, as long as you go into the preferences and manually enable the eGPU for rendering. And in this test, we got an extra 8 FPS in the timeline using dual monitors with the 5700 XT compared to the other cards, which shows that the benefits are not only limited to Final Cut Pro. But in exporting, once again, we didn't see any speed improvements with the extra display, but it's still quite a lot faster than the other cards. We then tested 4K Blackmagic RAW noise reduction, and the 5700 XT matches the Radeon 7 for having the best performance. Now going back to Final Cut Pro, we exported an 8K Red RAW clip into 4K, and this time, the Radeon 7 was the clear winner, quite a lot faster than the 5700 XT with the single monitor, but not too far ahead of the dual monitor setup. The reason the 7 performed so well in this test is because it has 16 gigs of VRAM compared to 8 on the other cards. So it seems like the only reason you should buy the 7 is if you absolutely know you need as much VRAM as possible. But even then, I would still recommend the 5700 XT because it was the winner in the rest of the tests, which is surprising considering it's the cheapest card out of the bunch. And finally, we tested Unigine's Heaven benchmark to simulate real-world gaming performance, and the 57 beat out the rest of the cards yet again. The reason we think it's faster is because it's using AMD's latest Navi technology, which comes with a lot of improvements, including hardware encoders that encode video footage faster than the older cards we tested in this video. And on top of that, we have one major reason why we think the 5700 XT is gonna get even faster very soon. Apple is currently working on releasing the W5700X graphics option for their Mac Pro, which is basically the same card as the 5700 XT. So that means that when they release that card for the Mac Pro, they'll also update the drivers as well, and the 57 should get a decent performance boost, as well as fixing the issues with the drivers. Now the Radeon 7 and Vega 64 cards are now so old that we don't expect Apple to improve the drivers on these cards anymore. So with that, let's answer the original question. Which graphics card should you buy for your eGPU setup? 100% no doubt about it, buy the 5700 XT, especially while it's on sale for $370 on Amazon using the link in the description below. And to deal with the driver issues until the upcoming update, we'll have links to the headless adapters as well. The 5700 XT will get you great performance right now and even better performance later. If this video helped you out, tap the like button, click the circle above to subscribe, and check out one of those two videos right over there. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you in the next one.